All right, Sherry at the Troll Hole Museum, unboxing today a package from Florida. Someone on Facebook reached out to me. There's actually an interesting story from Kelly Wade. So she posted a few trolls on Facebook, and I just happened to be scrolling on Facebook and saw the trolls that she posted for sale. I said, wow, there's some ones that I'd like to have in the collection, because I do have a bucket list of trolls that I'd love to add to my collection. Even though I have over 25,000 pieces of trolls, troll dolls, and troll merchandise, I have a long list of trolls that I'd like to see added to the collection that I can share with you, my guest, ones that are more unique and special. So the interesting thing was, when I told Kelly that I was interested in purchasing her trolls for the museum, she said, oh, my mother has some interesting pieces of memorabilia she'd like to send to the museum. And I said, great, because I do unboxings and I'd love to see some personalized information about trolls. Well, she said, her mom and her dad watch my YouTube videos. So thank you so much, all you folks out there that watch, subscribe, like, and share my content on my YouTube channel. This was a huge learning curve for this old troll to figure out YouTube, how to do it. So thank you to all those YouTubers out there that teach other people how to use YouTube. Thank you for watching, and on to the unboxing to see what special surprises are in the box waiting for me from Florida. Troll collector wants to share their trolls with us here at the museum and what special things she might have put in here. So we have a really cool dude here, like a soft squeaky toy. Little scuba diver there. See a little bit of the butt crack there. Crap. All right, we just pulled out of the bag this lovely dude with painted on shorts and crack. I have some of these in the museum, but each troll only needs to be different in one way. So this little dude with the purple hair and the yellow flippers on might be able to be included. I'll have to double check that. Within each type, there's many variations. Aha, this is a really special, the one that caught my eye when I saw the Facebook post. So these were called Glebes, made by the Russ Company. It doesn't have a year on them, but it was right around between 92, 94. There's a whole series of five or six of them. So I have one in my collection, and there's a special place in the museum with an astronaut and a space station where this fellow will be joining the Glebes. What else do we have here? Oh, a very special Wee Troll Kids Bobo. So there's your holiday coming up. Wee Troll Russ Kids Bobo. Let's see if they had a particular year on him, but the Rustberry Company made them brand new with the hang tag. It has a little story inside about trolls. So we're talking about those legendary trolls, not the troll dolls, but the history of the trolls written inside the little Russ hang tag. Russ was the manufacturer that made troll dolls from 1960 up till 2003. Tells where to find the trolls, how they only come out at night. They'll show you where gold and gemstones are, and how trolls originally came from the Scandinavian countries. So I am not sure that I have this cute little holiday in my collection. So that was one of the things that I spotted when I was thumbing through Facebook. Here we have some Norfin. This was the toddler, came out around the early 90s. Here's a generic fellow. He has one hand that's a little curled like that, a little grasp. Those are some trolls that might end up being customized. Here it looks like she has some hang tags, a troll kid, and a hatchling. That was Russ's little dinosaur. There's a really old looking stamp, the Power of Wishnick. So this was a little hang tag that came from the Wishnicks. And from those pictures, it looks like it's in Roman letters, 83. So it says, the far reaches of outer space and the sister planets of Zon and Gert, the bad luck Nicks, possess terrifying powers, the power to bring bad luck, misfortune, and wreak havoc. Wow, so this is all about evil trolls. Talking about Wishnicks, which were made by the You Need a Doll Company. Can you see that? Interesting. We'll talk more about the Wishnicks, but that's an older hang tag, and she is member of the Scandia House Worldwide Troll Club. So Scandia was a company in Florida by Ingrid Dines. 1965 is the date on that. So this was the original worldwide troll club. The Norfins did a club, and there were some other different companies that had clubs as well, but this was the first US company that did a club based on the trolls from Denmark, the Dom Thing, or Damn Thing Company. This was the hang tag for the more recent Russ, and we have a little Cardinals shirt here. Over there is where I have my sports trolls. The Rustberry Company was the one that owned the franchise for baseball and football, and I will get one that this will be redressed in and added to the collection, or it's a little yellowed. We might wash it up a little bit, hand wash it there with some Dawn. So there's a little Cardinals outfit. What else do we have? Our odds and ends. Wow, this is a new one. Treasure Trolls at Play. Treasure Trolls by the Ace Company came out in 1992 with a set of children's books, which I happen to be sitting right next to here. See? And it looks like on the back, very similar. And this is, of course, a coloring book with the Treasure Trolls. So it's a series of four coloring books that match the series of four storybooks. And it looks like it's in pretty good condition. None of the pictures have been colored on. Very nice. Got the original tag on it. Looks like it came out 1992. Yes, that's when Treasure Trolls launched in 1992. The magic gemstone in the belly, that was their claim to fame. All right, let's get into this bag. Lots of little goodies. We have parts and pieces, a shoe, but let's look at the trolls first. Ooh, here's one. This looks kind of like she's got a bonnet here, pink bonnet. Don't know, this might've been a custom dress. This is the first time I've seen. These are made by Toys and Things Company, lesser known company. On the bottom of the foot is where it says, made in China, 1991. TNT. She's got some big eyes going on there. And this is the first time I've seen one with such a dress as this. It could be a custom dress and it has like a little baby bonnet on it. So that is really super cool. That will for sure be added to the collection. People so lovingly take care of their trolls when they mail them in to me. From collecting my own trolls, now I'm a steward that saves people's trolls. Oh my goodness, goodness, goodness. Here is a Lucky Schnook. So this was from 1960s. It was a copycat type of troll made in Korea. They're kind of evil and not too happy looking. They got a frown on their head, a little bit of rabbit's fur on the back of their head. Lucky Schnooks is one of the names that they were sold under. So that is super cool. I know I haven't had any this size. I have some that are slightly larger. It's a really lightweight plastic. There we go, Lucky Schnooks. Wow, big score today. Really, really treasure that. Love it, love it, love it. Let's see what else treasures we have in here. I do not remember seeing that in the picture. Here's another one of our TNT trolls, little wedding troll. She's got her veil going on there. Really nice condition, pretty clean clothes. Probably have that one. Oh my goodness, we got us one of the smallest trolls. You can see in comparison, teeny little trolls sold in gumball machines. This one, someone, after they got it, pasted on a little dress. Very, very cool. We have a special case with all the small trolls. Now we have a battle troll. These were pretty common because trolls aren't just baby dolls for girls, they're boy toys. Battle trolls, warrior trolls, ninja trolls, soldier trolls. He's got his skates on, so you know he's up with the times. Came out around 90, 92. Little battle troll. And, oh yes, I love these little ones. They don't have any markings on them. Made of kind of rubber, but they're not squishy. That's how you get the troll hair looking nice. Give it a good shake. We have a special section in our museum with our dino trolls. So this one looks pretty familiar to me. He might be slight variations in color, but I think I might already have him in the museum. But I will add him in there and keep him a safe place because these are more rare and uncommon. So I'm not much of a troll trader. I don't buy and sell much. I do have quite a nice supply of trolls for sale in the gift shop, but they tend to be the Russes or the most common trolls. But the more rare ones, don't have too many of. These were put out by Burger King through Burger King's Kids Club. They're video kids. All right, here's one of the Norphins. It looks like she's got a little handmade. So very similar to this one here, but you see one has a little bit of white under the eyes. This is the baby doll Norphins. Norphins came out in a variety of sizes and styles. You can see their little hands positions, sometimes down, sometimes up. Quite a lot of variations in the Norphin trolls. Last one we have in the bag here is the holiday one. I do have this one in the collection. Got a lot of beautiful white fluffy hair. Little Norphin looks very much like this one next to him. As you can see, it's slightly darker and they're made for the holidays. And on the bottoms of the feet, they say DAM because the original Dom company did authorize the Norphin company to make these troll dolls. And here we have what we call our little made in Korea copycat. There he is. They were usually sold naked, really lightweight plastic again, similar to this, but these kind of things morphed more into this. So you can see the resemblance there between the two. Beautiful, beautiful collection of trolls. So this was her mother's. She sent it here to be loved at the Troll Museum. I see a couple other ones in here that were sold as pencil toppers, gumball machines. She has a whole assortment of these little ones. Let's see. So we'll start with the ones that look alike. These have a little hang tag on the back of them. Got a red one, a blue one, yellow one, and then a blue one with white hair. These are all actually a variety of sizes here. Real cool. There's another one, but it's even smaller with no hair, or sometimes they had some really strange hair, but they got a spot there to glue it. So I tend to just keep the trolls the way I find them. I don't change them up much. Here we got another little dino troll. It's gonna go with our dragon troll. I'm familiar with these. I have quite a few of these little ones. And they were sold as dino trolls in little containers. So here we have two little guys. They got really pointed noses, little hang tags on the back. This one's got a red tongue. This one doesn't. So these were non-franchised, sold as necklaces and charms. So I have these in the museum, but I really like them because they have that really pointy nose. This one was the treasure troll small version. These are not pencil toppers, they're just little dolls. He's got a round circle on his belly to represent that gemstone. So these were the miniature treasure troll ones. Now here is a pencil topper. It's got the hole between his leg. This was a generic one. Once again, kind of a copycat. So this one had not so pointy nose and a little bit more oval features. Very subtle differences, but really, really cool. Pretty sure I have this. I might have it with different colored hair. So here's a teeny tiny one for comparison. You can see how small that is, and even comparison to the pencil toppers. This one, they've done a reproduction of this more recently, but this is the ones from the 70s, 80s, somewhere in there, could be 90s. Don't have all the dates because there was so much troll merchandise out there, but he's carrying flowers. Sometimes these are painted pink and green. Pretty cool little guy there. We'll be checking him out. And one more, another really, really tiny one. Once again, there's three versions of the little trolls. Look at that. Someone's done him a service by putting some blue pants on him. Really, really nice selection with a bunch of variety there. You can see the differences, very similar, but all distinctly different. Love it, love it, love it. And now we have some outfits. So I will be taking some generic troll dolls and dressing these, and then they can be added to the collection because this is a cute little outfit that I've never seen the likes of. This one looks slightly familiar. There's the nurse's outfit. That's a ribbon, familiar with that. There's the nurse's cap. And we have assortment of shoes and combs. So what a haul, love it. Going to be able to add a bunch of these to the collection from Kelly from Florida. Let's take a look. What are my picks here? Oh, these got to be my two. I can't quite say two, three. There we go. Favorite picks from this unboxing. Troll unboxing at the Troll Hole Museum in Alliance, Ohio. Plan your next visit. Watch for our virtual. We're going to be adding virtual services so that you can take our guided, interactive, educational, and funny tour here at the Troll Hole Museum from the safety, security, and comfort of your own home. Thank you so much for sharing, liking, and watching my videos. Trolls bring you good luck. We love them. Keep trolling. It's been trolltastic.